Ephesians 1:1, Paul, an apostle of Christ Jesus by the will of God, to the saints who are in Ephesus and are faithful in Christ Jesus, grace to you and peace from God our Father and the Lord Jesus Christ. The book of Ephesians is considered to be the most concise, theologically rich book in the Bible. This is a survival manual for Christians. This is how you can survive and thrive, he's going to tell them, in the midst of a world that is not friendly to your message. Verse 5, when we were dead in our sins, he made us alive together with Christ. We used to be in a graveyard. Now we're in this growing, flourishing garden. Are you killing sin actively right now, or is it killing you? Are you gaining ground or losing ground? Are you in the fight? Don't you think that means you should do all you can to bring inside those who are still disconnected from eternal life? That if the people in your city, your school, your neighborhood, your family are ever going to hear the gospel, it's going to be through your mouth. This great God has put all of his resurrection power into us so that he can bring us his salvation and healing to the world through us. Before the world was ever established, before any of this had ever been made, God knew you. He knew your name and he loved you. That's what happens when you meet God in the story of Jesus. It's a story with such beauty and power and drama in it that just getting swept up into it forever changes you. It's not behavior modification, it's soul transformation at the core level. So you see, as Paul nears the end of the book of Ephesians, he's trying to get the Ephesians to see that in all their relationships, even the most normal relationships, they're actually serving God and putting God on display. Paul's prayer here, I am praying for you also, that you would see the hope that God has given you in the gospel, that you would see that he's in control and that he's working in all things, that you would understand your great worth to God, that you would recognize the power God has put inside of you, and that you would ask God to extend that power through you to people all over the world who have yet to hear about him. Amen. Amen.